Persian Lessons out in theaters in Poland, although the film has had a really drawn-out release schedule, being out in some countries a full year ago already, and then slowly opening in more and more territories. It's a period piece based on a short story that in turn was based on a supposedly real story. 1942 France, Nazi Germany is rounding up the Jewish people to put them in concentration camps, or in some cases to execute them straight away. Gilles, the main character, coincidentally comes in possession of a book written in Farsi, which he uses as proof to desperately convince the soldiers that captured him that he is not in fact Jewish. He claims to be Persian instead, modern-day Iran. He is extremely lucky because one of the officers of the concentration camp is looking for a Persian. Officer Koch is fascinated with Persia. He intends to move to Tehran after the war and he wants to learn the Farsi language. He strikes a deal with Gilles. In exchange for Farsi lessons, he'll keep the young prisoner safe, putting him to work in the camp's kitchen as well as bookkeeping. Gilles accepts because what else can he do? But obviously he doesn't speak a word of Farsi, so he begins frantically inventing a fake language word by word by word just to stay alive. So the story on paper is pretty amazing, as it's built around this tension whether or not Gilles can maintain the illusion, can fool the officer. However, I don't think that this idea manages to support the weight of a full feature film, at least not as it is. There's simply not enough of that main storyline to fill the 2 hours. It feels like there's this very specific set of plot points that the movie kind of goes through like a checklist, but then it doesn't have a good idea of what to do in between them. And instead of using that time to, for example, explore the character of Gilles more, which I felt was underdeveloped, it pads the runtime with a subplot involving a soldier that suspects Gilles and his girlfriend in camp, and their sort of interpersonal politics with the other officers. The problem is, this subplot ends up going pretty much nowhere, and it just feels like unnecessary filler. All the while, we learn very little of who Gilles is as a character outside of his desperation to survive. I mean, the film ends and you can't really say a lot about him, how he is as a person. As a result, the movie feels a bit middling and meandering, especially in the middle part. I have to admit, I was getting somewhat bored. The one shining point of the film is Lars Eidinger as Klaus Koch. I think he gives a fantastic performance, which on the one hand taps into the monstrosity of the Nazis, on the other manages to humanize his character, show that when you forget the xenophobia and cruelty, there is still a semblance of humanity inside of him. I think Eidinger's acting is the reason it works so well. Koch ends up becoming a much more fascinating character than Gilles, and I wonder if the movie doesn't actually overdo it, because at the end I actually didn't feel particularly strongly about Gilles one way or the other, whereas I did feel bad for Koch, for what happens to him in the end. So I do have to question whether that was really the movie's intention, to make me sympathize with the Nazi. That aside though, I think that this one strong performance isn't enough to carry the film, and the fact is that it's somewhat tedious and boring throughout, and that means that I can't wholeheartedly recommend it. I still think it has the skeleton of a terrific story, but the way that the film builds around that skeleton just didn't convince me in the end. I do think it would work much better as a short film.